Are you ready to party and learn something new about weird prosthetic pieces that I learned in a very roundabout way that was not intentional, it was kind of a mistake this morning? Good, you're in the right place. Let's dive in. Well, hello there, my beautiful, lovely, talented, and delightful internet friends. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me here today on Footless Joe, where I am definitely still Joe, and I am definitely still missing a foot, but I think we can say missing a foot times two after this morning's fiasco. Now, this was not a video I planned on making. I had this whole other plan for the morning of like going around to different spots in Colorado Springs outside and like talking about the year in review and some cool things that have happened, blah, blah, blah. Life had other plans, all right? And now you get this video, which I think is probably even cooler, but also worse for me. You'll understand what I mean in just a moment. Today, you, my lucky friend, are going to be gifted with the present of seeing the insides of what happens on a prosthetic foot. It's actually a little bit cooler and weirder than you might think. Have you ever found yourself wondering what's inside a prosthetic foot? I know it kept me up many nights before I got one myself. Before we go any further, if you would not mind hitting that like button, hitting that subscribe button, maybe ring the bell notification if you feel like it. It would help to alleviate the deep and everlasting shame that I feel from what you're about to see. So over the weekend, my leg here decided in all its brilliance that it was gonna stop keeping suction, meaning every step that I take, there's a slight hissing sound and it doesn't properly suction onto my leg. That makes walking really uncomfortable after a short period of time. So I tried a bunch of things to fix it. I tried changing the sleeve here. Okay, maybe there was a hole. That wasn't it. I tried even changing the liner. Maybe that had something to do with it. It wasn't it. I tried like blowing out like any valve or anything like that. Maybe there was a piece of dirt or sand or something like that. It wasn't that either. So flash forward to this morning when I thought, I'm gonna put this on one more time and just see. Is it still broken? Did it magically fix itself overnight? No, in case you're wondering. The magical prosthetic gods did not heal it overnight. But I put it on and then got in my head that maybe the hissing noise wasn't coming from the socket or the valve, which is right here. Maybe the hissing was something going on with the foot. Now, I want to let you know that this actually doesn't make any sense because the foot has nothing to do with the suction system, but I was still like, maybe that's what's going on. And I know that I was given this tool right here. I knew that this tool was for removing your prosthetic foot from its housing. Now, I do want to address the elephant in the room and say that yes, I have had this leg for just about a year and a half now, and I have never taken off the foot or cleaned that out. That, darling viewers, was a mistake. So after much struggle, like I got this wedged in here, I popped the foot off and was shocked at what I found in here. All right, first of all, I'm gonna take you on a brief walkthrough of the different pieces that we are looking at here. First of all, we have my foot, the actual foot shell, which is surprisingly light, absolutely disgustingly dirty inside because again, I haven't cleaned this out in a year and a half, which was a mistake. Also featured is the giant hole in my toe. As I was rinsing this out, it was just like pouring water out the toe, which was quite the visual. So this is really just cosmetics though, because what actually allows me to walk the way that I'm able to walk is down here. What is this weird sock piece, you might ask? And yes, I know this is disgustingly dirty, and no, I haven't cleaned it yet. And yes, I am going to shortly. I didn't wash this off specifically so I could show you, if you happen to be an amputee, that you should really probably take your foot off more often than once every almost 2 years. It's just caked in dirt. But what is this piece here? So this is a Kevlar sock. More dirt falling, even though I already, emptied that out earlier. The carbon fiber actual foot. So this right here is what actually allows me to walk. It's actually really cool. You may recognize kind of the look and the shape from the running blade, like it's just this curved carbon fiber, right? It has the split toe here, which serves a couple different purposes. First of all, it allows for more back and forth movement. And secondly, it makes it so that I can wear split toe shoes if I felt so inclined. Now, because this here is carbon fiber, it would eat its way through this in a heartbeat. So this Kevlar sock here has been on it for a year and a half now, protecting my foot shell from the actual mechanics of the foot, the metal pieces, the carbon fiber pieces. I swear I even washed this off too and it's still gross. I don't know if I'm gonna keep this in the video or not, but I just need you to know, please, please, if you're an amputee, please clean out your pieces more often than I have. I'm sure someone told me to do this at one point and I was like, cool, cool, I'll get to it. And then I never got to it because this is so crusted in dirt that it's like holding the shape of the foot when there's nothing in there. I am a little grossed out by myself. All right, so here we have really the three pieces that make up a prosthetic foot. The carbon fiber foot itself that allows me to walk, the Kevlar sleeve that protects it, and the foot shell in size 23R. So once I had successfully determined that no, there was no weird hissing or clicking sound coming from my foot, you know, I tried it on just like this. Okay, it really is the suction, it's not performing properly, it's all here. I went to go put it back together. And I could not get it back on. I could not get my foot back on. In what other context does that sentence even remotely make sense? So there I sat in my bathroom on the edge of tears. No, I thought I would just start laughing hysterically instead, because here's the problem. When I went to go put this back together, this split toe, right? It's really important that you get it on the split toe, and I could not do that to save my life. I'll demonstrate. Very important that we get the split toe on there. All right, cool, sounds good, easy enough. Take the foot, let's pop this back on here. Even using this to try to like grab it back on the back, I cannot get it. I cannot get that toe to like pop into the right place to line up with the split toe of my foot shell. I can't do it. So in desperation, God, this looks great. In desperation, I called my sweet prosthetics office and said, help me, I've made many mistakes. And they were kind enough to take pity on me and fit me in later today. So Zach and Tyler are going to assist me. And I would feel really dumb for going in for an appointment to be like, I can't get my foot back on, even though this is a skill I probably should have learned as a baby amputee. But on top of that, I am still having the hissing and lack of suction piece. So I figure it makes sense to go in for an appointment anyways, and I'm really grateful they could fit me in today. Now, I cannot look at this a second longer, and I'm also ashamed to show it to them in its disgusting state, so we're gonna take just a moment to hopefully clean some of this out. Am I disappointed in myself? Yes. Am I a little bit ashamed? Also yes. Am I gonna stop that from posting this on the internet for everyone to see? I'm not sure yet. This is so gross. I just need you to take a look at some of the water that is coming from this Kevlar sock. It is so dirty. Okay, but just being real, this does kind of look badass, doesn't it? Now we have slightly less shamefully dirty and disgusting pieces that I won't have to be as ashamed to show my prosthetist. It is kind of cool not only knowing, but like seeing the different parts and pieces that go into allowing me to walk. Like if it was just this right here, as cool as this looks, I could never walk because that carbon fiber would dig in and leave dents on absolutely anything I walked on. And if it was just made out of this, I wouldn't be able to walk very long at all because I'd be cutting holes into things all the time and it doesn't have the strength or stability. Obviously the carbon fiber has. If it was just these two together, I'd be going through foot shells like nobody's business because this Kevlar sock wouldn't be there to protect one from the other. Thinking about this whole process and all the different bits of engineering and thought that had to go into it are really cool. Like what I have here is an absolutely incredible device, though I may get frustrated at it in moments when it will not suction to me and thus does not allow me to walk. It is still pretty darn cool. So anyways, that is our very impromptu and fairly exposing myself video of what is in the inside of a prosthetic foot and what actually makes up these parts and pieces. Also on a side note, I've mentioned this before, these pieces right here are the only pieces to my knowledge that are replaceable that insurance will not cover. So I just have a hole in my toe that is slowly being eaten through by this Kevlar sock and the carbon fiber underneath that will continue to grow as it already has and eat through more of the foot and eventually make it so I can't walk without buying a new one on my own. And these are not cheap. It's just really weird to me that these are the one pieces that cannot be replaced, but hey, I don't make the rules, I just have to abide by them. And with that being said, I think I'm actually gonna go scrub these down a little bit further because after watching the drawing, I noticed that they are still pretty gross and I'm gonna fix that. But thank you for hanging out with me and listening to me talk for a little bit about the different prosthetic parts and pieces. To all of my patrons, I appreciate each and every one of you more than I can ever tell you. Thank you for supporting this channel and allowing me to do what I do here. I do not take you for granted, but I am eternally grateful for you. And to you watching this video right now, thank you for spending a few minutes out of your day here with me today. You could be anywhere in the world doing anything else, and you chose to spend a few minutes with me, and that means a lot to me, so thank you. I love you guys, I'm thinking about you, and I will see you in the next video. I'm not gonna kiss my hand because I feel like it still has dirt on it from all that cleaning, so we'll just blow a kiss from there. Bye, guys. Have her from the sky.